I'm Dave Seaman, and my colleagues on the village board that help make this government work. We've got our clerk Pat Ray, trustee Brian Maher, trustee TJ Grady, trustee Brian Yonker, trustee Jake Vandenberg, and trustee Mike Benito that are part of today's team that will take the village forward beyond where it basically left us such a great foundation to start. We also have with us today some dignitaries. We've got ourselves State Senator Mike Hastings this year. Representative Al Riley. Representative Barbara McDermott. We're also fortunate to have a group of mayors with us. And if the mayors would each rise and identify themselves, inability to do so, or please rise. And I know, Dan, why don't you start?
Dan McLaughlin, Oral Park.
Debbie Myers Martin, Olympia Fields.
Mary Brandon, President Pro Tem, Park Forest.
Thank you. I'd like also for we've got a number of township representatives. If they'd at least please rise. I know I saw Norm and a few other people here. If you rise just to be recognized, we appreciate it. Thank you, Norm. We've got some Park District officials elected. Dr. Mahoney's here. We also have a special group of people, and I think when you're in office as long as that is, you get a lot of people that have served on your boards. And with us tonight, we have a number of Castonley Park trustees that are here. If they please rise and introduce themselves, so that Ed can remember you. I don't know if he forgot. Carl Vandenberg in the rear there. Thank you all for coming. This is an important day. At this point in time, I would like the Honorable Patrick E. Ray, our village clerk, to come up and share a few comments.
Thank you, David, and to our wonderful guests that are here, and we can welcome you all. I would just have a few words, and no one's going to believe it. But the fact is that the folks that are here underscore one thing, and that is the commitment of Eddie to the village, but the commitment of each of you to public service. So let me discuss public service for a minute, because all of you do it. In fact, this room is a fountainhead of public service. We see a young state senator who decided that's what he wanted to do after he graduated from West Point. Not a bad trick for public service. We see a state house member who's probably the leading wonk in public policy in Illinois. Not a bad thing for public service. We see a group of mayors, all of which have given just about everything, because there's nothing at the local level which is sacred. Small s, Father, small s. I know I'm a Baptist, I can't spell sacred, but nevertheless. Reminds me of a little story when I was introduced to some good apostolics, and one of them said, Baptist, that's near a Christian. At any rate. So let's use the standard of Ed Zabrocki with you, with each of you. because every single person in this room, the commissioners, the business leaders, have gone a step beyond. And it's that step beyond that Zebraki exhibits in abundance. What are the characteristics of a public servant? First, they're unselfish. There is no two ways about it. They're motivated, unselfish. Regretfully, some think there's piles of money under every pillow I've been thrashing around looking. But they're first unselfish. Secondly, even though one might think otherwise, they're much above average in intelligence. Why? The reason you might think otherwise is that that's popular to do. Why? Because they have to not just see the issue, but to see the impact. The definition of intelligence is the ability to understand relationships. That's it, beginning and end. That's the definition of intelligence. Mayors must see the impact of what they're going to do or they're not going to be around long. Trustees must. Certainly state senators, certainly state house members. So the intelligence measurement of a local official is even higher than others, because the next thing is, they don't have a tough skin. Let me say to you, and this is a secret you all know, you are just as wounded daily as almost anybody can. And you feel it. It just isn't any other way. And it's only with the first point, the unselfishness and then the commitment to your community, that allows you to sort of say, I'll shake that off. Inside, if you know public officials, as each of you do, because most of you are, you know that it hurts every single time. So the dimension of the fourth point after that is a commitment to your district, to your community, in this case, to your town. Now, Ed is the father of Tilney Park. I say that with some degree of reservation because there's only two kids that he's had. But he's been father to grandmothers. He's been fathers to aunts and uncles over his age, as each mayor in this room has been. The unsung hero of the United States, the thing that makes this democracy different after a wonderful constitution, is the commitment of the local person to give their time, their talent, and in some cases, their funds to carry out the work of this republic. In every single embassy I've mentioned, Ed Zebraki stands foremost. And you are the next 500 points in the speech, because each of you say to him, he's done it. It is impossible to overstate how important a dinner like this is, an event like this is, when it's not political patronage. It's not because you have something else to do. Thank God the Blackhawks aren't playing. I had to bring that up. It's not those things. It is, in fact, that you're here because you're honoring one of your own who has given so much. Now, I could go on, and there's no one in this room that doubts that. But the manager has told me, he was in the office today at 4 o'clock when somebody came by and said, Patrick's going to have to say a few words. There was laughter in the office. He said, let's see what a few words looks like. But then I must conclude with some thank yous. Thank you first to Ed and Emily, to their sons, to their grandchildren that are so central to their life. Thank you to the neighboring elected officials. It's been my honor to serve our country in different ways, and quite often right across the border to Canada. I'm in fact an officer of the Royal Regiment. I never stopped saying to my Canadian friends, we couldn't have a better neighbor. I never stopped saying to Orland Park, we couldn't have a better neighbor. You just don't have them better than that. And that mayor is here, and his town is great. Every one of the mayors that are here are distinguished in their contribution. So in conclusion, yes. Mainly because I see somebody back there with a hook. In conclusion, I just have to say this. It has been 34 years of pleasure for me to work with Ed Zebrocky. I was a trustee before he was mayor. I was so glad to see him come aboard. And I'd be very happy to serve a few more days at least after he leaves. But what a pleasure. And again, everyone in this room has traveled. I extensively and still do. They just don't come better than Ed Zebrocky. Thank you.
Before I get in trouble from the CRC, I want you to know that there is a special booth that is in the room next door for you to do personal, special messages to Ed. These will not be aired on TV. They will not be, so we're gonna assume they're gonna be clean, but you know, there's a booth over there where the CRC is gonna be recording these messages about a minute long, so that you don't have to think a lot of you know, putting time into it, but that was a thought that the CRC chair had for you to try to give Ed something to bring home that really communicates, I think, the love that each of us have for Ed and Emily. The,
can I say something?
Sure, Joe.
I'm the commissioner for 40 years here at Tivoli Park, and I want to express our thanks, maybe to all the commissioners that are here, especially our thanks for Ed and his service to Tivoli Park.
I'd like Ed to come up here for a moment. Emily first, though. Emily, you have to come up first. There's only one job that's probably worse than being, well, maybe it is worse than being mayor, I don't know, and that's being the first lady. The time away, and I think John is here and he knows it, family knows it, it's difficult being away. And to do what you do, this is really tiny. But we can't thank you enough for giving us that. Again, this is reflective of this job not being one person's job. It's a family role. It's a family engagement. So, John, coming up.
John's bashful. Where's Iris and Emily?
This is your mother speaking.
That are going to be presented right now before Ed makes some closing remarks. I'd like Representative Al Riley to join us.
Thank you so much. Thank you for all being out here, doing something that comes natural to all of us. That's honoring a great man as a Rocky. I have a resolution from the House of Representatives. Let me just do this, because coming up here, I said, let me do something a little different. I'm Assistant Majority Leader in the House, and I sponsored House Resolution number 564, and it has a lot of whereases. And so, and it's, but, you know, what can I say? You know how they're organized. But why don't I do this off the cuff? It was something we adopted May 30th, signed by Tim Mates, the Clerk of the House, Mike Madigan, the Speaker of the House. But let me just speak to you from my heart. And that is to say this, in the pantheon of great mayors in this state, and we are a great state with a great history. We've had some great mayors, and not just mayors of the city of Chicago, but mayors all over this state that really cared about their people and got their hands dirty. You know, we were talking earlier about the importance of local officials. When Alexis de Tocqueville came over here to study the penal system, one of the things that he marveled over was going and seeing Grange organizations and small cities and villages and how people came together to solve problems. And for a lot of us out here in the suburbs, it's exactly what we have done. So there have been a lot of great mayors. But frankly, when that pantheon is set up, I can't see anyone, maybe they'll tie him, but I can't see a better mayor than Ed Zebrocky has been. And I have that policy wrong, and I'm not given to a lot of hyperbole, but it's just true. And first of all, give a hand to Pat Ray, please. Microphone he didn't like, but if Ed Zebrocky is Ike, certainly Pat Gray is a Omar Bradley. You've got some really good people here, but this is a man who has taken all of his time in helping to build Tinley Park into what it is now. And you can be proud of yourselves, because all over the state, they know where Tinley Park is. I know where Tinley Park was when I was a kid growing up, because I used to like the Indy 500. But after that was all over, it was Ed Zebrocky's town. So we're really glad to be here, Ed. This isn't an end. You will always be my friend. And just like, you know, they say in the French Foreign Legion, I wasn't a legionnaire, but I know something about special operations. But one of the things that they say is, if you ever need me, no matter where you are in the world, just give me a call within 48 hours, I will be there. And that's the way I feel about you. Thank you so much.
I want to start by saying I can never be as eloquent as Pat Ray or Al Riley. I went to Andrew High School. In the room, surrogate parents to myself, and it's truly an honor to stand before my town as your state senator. But today it humbles me to speak, because I've known Ed Zebrocky since the seventh grade. And surprising to some of you who may not know this, I look up to Ed as a leader, as a role model, and as a father figure. Having a father who's been involved in politics for as long as my father has been, I could tell you that there's two striking comparisons between the two. And I like to blend those leaders together, and I think it's made me who I am today. My military experience, I've had the opportunity to work with great general officers like General Petraeus, General Casey Odierno. I worked with great military retired general officers like General Pat Gray. I can tell you that it makes me very proud to hold Mayor Zebrocky in the same regard as I hold those leaders that I served with in combat in my civilian service. But I too have a proclamation that was sponsored in the Senate, and I don't want to bore everybody with all the whereases. I just want to read probably the two most important tenets inside the proclamation. And I think they're very important because I think everybody will attest to this. Edward J. Zabrocki, in his 34 years of public service, has made Tinley Park into one of the best communities to raise a family in the United States. He's known in the community as a coach, a guidance counselor, a friend, a husband, a father, a grandpa, and an all-around great guy. And his leadership's going to be sorely missed, but his legacy will be remembered for years to come. And I want to tell you that we may have had some differences in the past, but our differences is what brings us closer together. And I think that down in Springfield, regardless of the difficulties we face, I know that I can always count on Ed for his opinion and his sage guidance. And I want to tell the Zabrocki family, thank you for your sacrifice. Your sacrifice as a family is far greater than the sacrifice as an elected official. And I want to wish you well in the many years of retirement. And I can't wait to see you down golfing in Florida. God bless you guys.
First of all, thank you all for coming. I appreciate it a great deal. Some other friends came in. Jim Holland from Frankfurt. Jim's a good friend for many, many years. Eunice from Congressman Bobby Rush's office. Eunice, thank you for coming. A lot of things go through your mind on a night like this. I asked my family to come up here, and I hope I can hold this together. I asked my family to come up here because I've always felt through the years that Tinley Park is a very family town. And what's interesting, at least with my family, I have seven grandchildren, and they run in seven different directions all the time. Tour and camp. Tour in New York, and they got some medical issues out in New York, so they couldn't come out. And but Tinley Park's a very, very family-oriented town, and something, excuse me, you have to bear with me. Where's Rose Seaman? Rose Seaman, where are you? Please stand up. New First Lady of Tinley Park. Points, right? But Tinley Park doesn't operate because of one person. It operates because of a lot of people, a lot of staff, commissioners, residents. I met a lady here earlier tonight. I'm not sure exactly where she's at, but I kind of did my thing and kind of thought I recognized her, which I didn't. Us politicians do that all the time. And she caught me on it. I says, "You don't know me, do you?" I said, "No, I don't." And she says, "You were at my house with some people when my condo burned." And that's the kind of town Tinley, there she is right there. That's the kind of town Tinley is. When someone's condo burns, all of our condos burn. And that's the idea, the concept that we're trying to have in our community. I feel very strongly about family. Maybe it goes back to my Eastern European background. My grandparents were immigrants, came over in 1908 from Poland. And I've been blessed through the years in many different ways. And you can see I prepared nothing because that's why I'm random all over the place. So bear with me. Somebody's been with me for 51 years, my wife Emily. And those of you who know me, you know what a challenge that is.